Is the motor on?
It's not working.
If I can reach it, I can make it turn.
Okay, here we go. Hold on, right into it.
Why are two grown men on a black swan boat?
I think I'm getting seasick, Rob.
About to be swamped off the coast of Brazil.
This is crazy!
This is Rob Mariano, a reality TV superstar.
This doesn't look good.
Shut us down!
And Dennis Anderson, the biggest name on the monster truck circuit. Their challenge is this: go around the world using 80 different forms of transportation. Anything is fair game, but whatever they choose, they can only use once.
Brakes, brakes.
This is the next chapter of an amazing journey called Around the World in 80 Ways.
Come on, man, giddy up.
Now watch out, watch where you're going.
You gotta be kidding me.
So far, the boys have burned 9 ways going from Southern California to Peru's Lake Titicaca.
Whoops, sorry.
Jeez.
Let's see how they do on the second leg. They need to travel 450 miles from Sao Paulo, Brazil's biggest city, to the sexiest beach in the world, Rio de Janeiro's Ipanema.
Sao Paulo, Brazil, man, check it out.
Wow, it's awesome, dude, it's huge.
Their starting point is a Sao Paulo rooftop, 35 floors above the teeming streets.
Jeez, I don't know how we're gonna get down, dude. What are we doing here?
Dennis starts off round number 2, a worried man.
Dennis, check this thing out. It's a window washer.
But Rob's already got his thinking cap on.
Yeah, no joke.
We can use this to get down.
I don't think so, dude.
Dude, this is a way.
A scaffolding set up for washing windows is definitely a way. It just might not be the safest way. It could wind up taking them from point A to point dead.
Look at these small cables and stuff, man. This thing is, this ain't no spring chicken here, buddy.
Look at how strong these beams are.
It goes right up the middle, and then it hangs us out.
Dude, I'm not gonna buy this. I mean,
you got a better idea?
No.
Oh my God.
No way.
It's a long way down.
No freaking way, man.
Window washing is always listed as one of the most dangerous jobs. The death rate from even a 3-story fall is 50%. Above 10 stories, almost 100%. But in 2007, a New York City window washer fell 47 stories and survived, nearly twice the size of the building the guys are on. He suffered 2 broken legs, an arm, and a shattered vertebrae. For Dennis and Rob, falling off the side of a skyscraper is one way of travel they don't want to try.
Look at, how hard can it be? There's like 5 buttons.
So, I mean, it's got an up and down, and I don't know if it's probably got a left and a right.
The safety harnesses
will clip you to the thing.
Look at, I've never done this before either.
Why are you so confident in it then?
Because I know that you're gonna be more scared than me, so that means I'll be all right.
Yeah, all right. You're not gonna get up here and goof around and think it's some freaking carnival ride.
I don't think it is, but it's a way to get down, isn't it?
This is bull crap.
Let's go, let's get suited up. Hey, you know what? Look at me, this is a memory.
Yeah, it's a memory, all right. Our last ride together.
Let's do it.
All right, let's do it, man. All we gotta worry about right now is this panel right here, dude. This is up and down. I gotta swing these booms.
We gotta go up.
Yes.
This one.
That, there you go. See, that runs the boom.
Whoa, whoa. Woo-hoo. Whoa, I don't know. Maybe this wasn't such a good idea. Do you know what you're doing?
Not really. Oh, yeah, I do this all the time, Rob.
All right, come on, just go quick. Let's get it over with.
Don't look down whatever you do, Rob.
Trying not to.
This is a little shaky, dude. I don't know about this. Hold on tight, because
it's the going out part.
Just don't look back.
All right.
I got us. Holy crap. I cannot believe that we're doing this.
Oh, wow.
If we bust these windows, we don't have to worry about getting a ride. We're going straight to jail. I'm telling you.
Oh, my goodness.
Let it go up. Let it go up a little bit. Unbelievable. Look, there's people inside.
Oh, my goodness.
Do we need permission to do this?
How the hell should I know?
Hold on, stop.
We're going to jail.
Man, we should probably wash some windows.
It's probably better that Dennis doesn't know that every year around the world, an average of 10 window washers fall to their deaths, most of them slipping on soap.
I am a window washer.
This is definitely not a way that I anticipated.
Hey, well, trust me, we get down here and there's somebody at the bottom that can't speak English, we're going to jail.
Will you stop swinging it?
Knees up, no pressure.
And you know what? You might be losing weight because we're under the 200 kilogram capacity. We're over. So you know what, though? They always rate those things a little higher.
Coming on down. Hey, Rob, come on, dude. Rob, hey, pay attention.
Hold on, let me untie you.
Come on.
Yeah, give me.
Holy moly.
That's a heck of a way.
That was a heck of a way.
Yeah, go.
Wait, what?
The boys figured a unique way down, but no one told this guy. They managed to get off the building.
Rio de Janeiro, here we come.
Here we come, baby.
But now they gotta get out of town.
You could race that thing.
Nah, that's too little. How about the pizza delivery guy? There's a hospital.
Should do an ambulance ride. Why haven't we done that yet?
Right? We haven't drawn blood or broke a bone.
It don't matter. We could just drive the thing. You get in the back and I'm like,
why do you have to drive?
Okay, you can drive, Dennis. You drive. Look at these two with the helmets. It's the police.
This is Chips, man.
Think we can get them to let us take it for a ride? I doubt it. Let's go find something to do.
So far, the boys aren't making much headway.
Something's going on.
What the hell?
Oh, no.
A street protest stops them dead in their tracks.
What are they doing, dude? That's what they were trying to do last week is what they said.
This is like the exact thing that we're supposed to stay away from when we're traveling outside of our country.
Right.
Political rallies and stuff. Let's go check it out. Hope it's not anti-American.
We're going for the march.
Chama o comando, chama o som aqui. Ah lá, deve ser de longe.
Yeah, parade in Brazil, baby.
Dope.
There's no hope in dope. We better get out of here.
Let's go. We gotta find another way.
Rio de Janeiro. Here we come.
Here we come, baby.
The boys make it to a truck stop on the outskirts of Sao Paulo. They need to start logging some miles and get their butts to Rio before the girls from Ipanema all go home.
I think we need to catch one of these trucks, man.
They spot a form of transportation you don't see every day, at least not in the U.S. It's called a road train.
He's got every wagon on this jewel packed up.
Yo, let me drive. Can I drive? I know how. You put the clutch in, turn it, start it up, clutch in. Oh, you know I know how to drive, huh?
A road train is a trucking concept invented in Australia to haul large loads of freight across the remote outback. The basic setup is a truck cab or a tractor unit hooked up to several trailers filled with cargo. In Australia, before there were road trains, there were camel trains. The outback was too harsh of an environment for horses or other beasts of burden. Camels were brought in from the Middle East and became the primary means of bulk transport.
Wow, man, look at all these fields. What is this stuff, corn?
No, it's sugarcane.
The road train the boys hitched a ride on is hauling a load of sugarcane that will be converted into ethanol fuel. Brazil is the world's second largest producer of ethanol and the number one exporter. Brazil also has the distinction of having the world's first sustainable biofuel economy. Good old boy Dennis knows all about homemade fuel.
We make it at home too. We make it with corn though. I use methanol alcohol in my truck.
What's the difference between methanol and ethanol?
Methanol, you can't drink it. Ethanol, you can drink it. You can get tore up from the floor up on this stuff, dude. And I guarantee you, this would be some sweet moonshine right here.
Wow, look at this machine, man. What is this? Wow, man, look at all these fields. What is this stuff, corn?
No, it's sugarcane. You don't see it don't have ears on it, man.
Massive road trains have gotten our boys to a sugar plantation only 50 miles from their destination, Ipanema Beach.
Wow, look at this machine, man. What is this?
That's a harvester.
And here they discovered a truly gnarly form of transportation.
Check it out, dude. It's spitting out the sugarcane by the stalk, and it chops it up, too.
I know it. It is cool.
These combines can knock down 50 acres of sugarcane in an hour. Their 300-horsepower engine slice and dice the cane into 12-inch stalks. The stalks are stripped and ride a conveyor belt to a chute, where they're blown into waiting trailers.
This is definitely another way we're going to have to try.
They're not going to let us screw around with that, man. That thing right there is at least $500,000, if not
just
more.
Just leave it to me, Dennis. I'll get them to let us use it.
You're right. Thanks for the ride.
Thanks,
that's
buddy.
Another way, bud.
As soon as the road train goes in the books as a way to travel, Rob is already nailing down the next one.
Me and my buddy, we want to drive.
Rob convinces the farmer to give up his combines for some playtime.
You gotta be kidding me. He's gonna get us all jammed up now.
You get in with Vinny, and I'm going with her. Okay, how do I drive this thing?
The loser gotta treat the winner for king for the day. All right, I got a copy on you there, buddy. King for the day, that'll be me, yep.
First one to the end of the field wins.
See you at the finish line.
Don't cheat. Don't cheat, Dennis.
You're already trying to inch your head on me.
Este máquina más rápido de aquí?
No, this one is faster, he already told me. We gotta beat them. We gotta beat them.
Hey, Dennis, how are we gonna stop this thing?
Go, 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 go.
Dennis is still smarting from Rob's Lake Titicaca reedboat win, so he decides to leave nothing to chance.
You don't even say go.
And jumps out to a head start.
Catching up there, buddy. That's okay. Trying to save this burst of nitrous for the end.
You need more power.
Come on, baby, come on, come on, bring it home. This is gonna be tight.
I can't let him win. I gotta cut him off if I have to.
Yeah! But once again, Dennis gets robbed by Rob.
Jeez.
Mr. Monster Truck is 0-2.
That was no good.
You didn't think I had that extra gear, huh?
You can just call me Your Majesty.
All right, Your Majesty.
Yeah!
Yeah! So what, I gotta wait on him. He's a punk.
come on over here and help me down, will you?
Yes, Your Majesty. Come on, right foot, left foot. Right foot, left foot.
Turn around.
Come on. Come on.
Let's go.
Yeehaw! All right, that's it. And that's another way. He's a punk, dude.
Oh, my goodness.
The window washer.
Can you stop swinging it?
A hitched ride on a road train.
Oh, this is nice back here.
And a harvester.
And what is this?
Is all well and good.
This is gonna be tight.
But in the end, it's just a truck and some farm equipment.
Yeah!
It's time for the boys to step it up and find something we haven't seen before. Bird's the word. Next up, an ostrich farm.
Check this out, Rob.
Do you think it's all right if we get in there with them?
Ostrich meat is being touted as the new beef, but the boys don't want to eat them. They want to ride them.
Hey, how you doing, man? We were just admiring your ostrich out there.
Yes, sir.
They're really cool.
Can you ride an ostrich?
You think they'll hold me?
I doubt it, but I mean, there's always, you can know, you can try it.
All right, we'll give it a shot.
Yeah, no problem.
All right.
Holler if you need help.
Well, I know these dudes can't fly, but I can tell you one thing. These guys can run 20 to 25 miles an hour. They got some big feet and some big legs. Look at the claws on them.
How are you gonna get them? We gotta lasso them.
You gotta lasso them?
Well, you're gonna go in there unprepared and he's just gonna run around.
I'm holding the gate for you, come on. Get in here.
You think we can corner him?
Dude, there's no way I can ride that thing. It's not that big once I get up
here. Hold on, buddy. Easy. Man. I think I gotta just go for a running jump and jump on.
Easy, buddy. Easy, buddy.
Hold on, hold on.
Whoa, baby.
Oh. All right, get on, Rob.
Go, go, go. Watch.
Do it, do it, do it. Come on.
Give me an arm.
Come on. That's not gonna work, dude.
No.
We got these horse buggies every once in a while for the fun of it. We just go and put these harnesses on them. And do like a buggy ride with ostriches. Have you ever heard of that?
No.
Why didn't you tell us that in the first place, bro?
Well, you didn't ask.
Coming up.
Just peck him in the face, please.
Rob and Dennis are in the middle of an ostrich farm in Brazil, looking to get their big bird race on.
We got these horse buggies every once in a while for the fun of it. We just go and put these harnesses on them and do like a buggy ride with ostriches. Have you ever heard of that?
No.
Why didn't you tell us that in the first place, Will?
Well, you didn't ask.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm sorry, babe. Come here. Yeah, I'd love to hook her to a cart. I want this one to be mine. Oh, Maggie. Oh, Maggie. All right, get in, Rob. Let's try it. All right. Hit them up, move them out.
Oh! Let's go a little faster, buddy.
Dude, that thing stings. Don't hit me with it. Drop this one down. Okay.
For monster truck champ Dennis, this could be another blow to his ego.
We'll race to the trees right up ahead.
All right.
The loser gotta make the winner lunch. Yeah! Yeah! Let's go! Andalay!
Come on, yeah. Come on. Come on.
Woo! Ha! Woo! Yeah!
Come on, man. Old Maggie's laying down on the job. Come on, babe. All right, Maggie. Let's get up. Come on. Screech, screech. Come on.
Yeah!
Come on. Come on.
Yeah, baby! Woo! Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Now we're talking! Now we're talking! Mr. Oscar! Whoa, 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 whoa! Whoa, get over to the left. Wrong way, brother. Whoa, 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 whoa!
Yeah, ha, ha! Oh, she's going down. God, what a turd bird.
Woo! We won. We're the champions.
There he goes. I hope it turns over. Keep going. Drag him out of here. I'm sick of his mouth. I hope she drags him off in the jungle.
Ha! 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 Let's go, brother.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
You, Maggie, you let me down, sweetheart. I'm gonna put you back out to the pasture.
Dennis's ostrich might have pulled up lame, but ostrich racing is alive and well in three continents across the world, with riders actually perched atop these large flightless birds. In the early 1900s, ostrich farms catered to the enormous fashion demands for ostrich plumes and feathers.
Listen, you're gonna make me lunch, you understand?
All right, it's okay. I got a little ride. It's all right, Maggie. I didn't get him this time, baby, but I'll get him the next time, okay?
Man, you must really miss your wife.
Just peck him in the face, please. Get up and peck him in his face.
All Dennis's sweet talking gets Maggie up and walking. Come on. And the boys get a ride into town.
Come on, come on. Go, baby, go.
Come on.
Let's go, baby. Ah! Man, I'm starving.
There's a little diner up here, dude. I'm gonna hook you up. I'm gonna cook you the finest meal you ever sunk your teeth in. I got you, dude. A bet was a bet. I think you're gonna be surprised, man. Look at that monster.
It should come as no surprise that the largest living species of bird lays the largest eggs of any bird in the world.
Ooh, boy, that's looking good. That's good. All right, Robbie, baby. I got it done for you. There you go.
I don't need eggs, Dennis.
Come on, man. After all that sweat in the kitchen, dude, come on, just try it, Rob.
Go for it.
All right, well, eat the toast anyway. You gotta eat.
It's touching the egg.
Not that piece. The toast is good.
It's touching the egg, though.
No, I just wiped. That little bit's not gonna hurt you, dude. These eggs are good, though.
It's time for the boys to scramble and go back on the hunt for another way.
Man, even the flies don't want to eat that.
You should have seen them eating it in the kitchen.
So far on their trek through Brazil, our touristas logged 5 ways to get them from Sao Paulo to where they are right now, a mere 23 miles from the outskirts of Rio de Janeiro.
We don't know what our next way is going to be. We may be walking for a while.
Their final destination for this leg is one of the most famous stretches of sand in the world. And hoping the boys make it to Ipanema this year, we put one of these in their path.
The hell is this thing?
Man, it looks like it's green.
Looks like a grocery cart to me.
That thing is a hand car, and if you're talking transportation, it's a pretty nifty way to go.
All right, baby, where's the key at for this thing?
You're looking at it.
All right, we're off.
We got them to get all the way to Rio.
Okay.
Whoa, look at that.
Better watch out, that bitch will choke off.
A railway car is a compound machine. The handle on the pump lever is attached to a connecting rod, which then attaches to an off-center pivot wheel. When the pump lever is pushed down, the axle makes the wheels on the car go down the track.
This thing smells like it's got a carburetor on it.
No, this is eco-friendly.
Is it?
It's green. It's the way of the future. That's the thing, we're not gonna be able to depend on oil forever.
Well, there'll be some more of these devices coming back in effect.
Can you imagine? It'll solve the obesity problem in our country.
Yeah. Why did you grin when you said that? You're looking at me?
I've been a little rough on you. It's only because I love you.
I'm starting to really kind of like you, dude. Not in a funny way. It's before you gig me. Yeah! I like this.
Man, this is a great way to get to Rio, huh?
It is, man.
Oh, I can't wait to get to the beach.
Dennis and Rob might not realize it, but they're sitting on a pretty interesting piece of transportation history. Originally made for railroad track inspection, hand cars have been put to work in mines, used as passenger vehicles, cargo carrying, and even recreational purposes. To this day, Japan has dozens of commercially operated hand car railway lines called human car tramways.
It's all downhill from here, baby. I never thought I'd see the day that I'd be on a railroad car.
I never thought I'd see the day that me and you'd be working together, teamwork. Woo-hoo-hoo!
Downhill on a hand car is a piece of cake.
Uh-oh. That, we're choking out right now.
Uphill is a different story.
Dennis, I think you're gonna have to push us.
All right, Rob. You're the king of the day.
It sure pays to be king.
Yeah, right now it does for sure.
Dennis's lame ostrich is coming back to bite him. He lost the race, and now he's sucking wind and pushing Rob.
Can you go a little faster?
Oh, go to hell, Rob.
Man, don't worry, Dennis. When we get to Rio, it'll all be worth it. All right. Hey, you know what, man? You better get on. You look like you're gonna have a heart attack. I can't lose you this early on.
All right.
Go ahead.
Whew. This is a relationship that we're building, Rob.
This is a relationship we're building?
Yeah.
All right, here I come.
You scratch my back, then I'll scratch yours. You break my arm, then I'll break yours.
Man, I didn't think we were ever gonna make it.
Oh, man, I'm glad we finally get this thing stopped. Rob, you need me to help you, buddy?
Are you kidding me?
You the man, Rob.
That's another way. Let's go.
Rio, baby, here we are.
Coming up.
This is the stupidest freaking thing we've done yet.
Rudder just broke.
Dennis and Rob have made it to Rio de Janeiro, which happens to be the most visited city in the Southern Hemisphere. They've chalked up 14 ways to travel since their adventure began. But right now, they're not thinking about transportation.
All right, let's go find something to eat, man. Here you go. Excuse me, you speak English? Huh? No?
A true innocent abroad.
You speak English? No, no?
Dennis has no problem pumping the locals for some good eating tips.
Hey, we want to go somewhere, something good to eat. Drink? No?
Don't know.
Don't know.
Man, what happened to his lip reading skills?
His lips were too tight, man. He just didn't, I couldn't, they didn't work. Yeah, try some of your Spanish on somebody, Rob.
Dude, we're in Brazil. It's not a Spanish-speaking country.
They might know it, though. It kind of sounds similar.
No, they speak Portuguese here. Let's find somewhere to get some dinner. We gotta ask somebody.
Hey, excuse me, where's a good place to get something to eat? Like a steak or?
In perfect English, they can say I don't speak English.
Oh, here you go. Ooh. Oh, yeah.
Man.
I thought you said it was in a bottle, dude.
It did. It was in a bottle, and then they poured it in
like
a glass.
It was like a wine glass or a candle.
No, that's what I mean. Isn't that weird? Thank you. That's weird. It's like, that's what happens when you leave the country. They serve beer in a wine glass.
Pretty good, though.
Cheers.
Cheers to a successful journey.
You're supposed to look
so
in my eyes when we cheers.
What?
That's what you're supposed to do.
I'll glance over there. Cheers.
Man, I can't do it. Where's our waiter? I can't drink beer out of a wine glass.
Now you're the prima donna. Don't whine about it, dude. God, the beer is cold. It's good.
I know, but it's a little bit fancy.
Good Lord, look at this.
Woohoo!
What?
Hey, how come we don't have a regular glass like everyone else? Look at, like, this guy. See, he has a mug.
Not for me.
Yay!
Oh, appetizer. Look at all this food.
Whoa. Yeah, make some room.
What is that?
Cow tongue? All set. No, thank you. You gonna eat that? Oh. Get it away from me. No, get it away.
Seems like Rob is a picky eater. He can't stand eggs, and his lips will never touch cow tongue.
Do it.
No.
Come on, dude.
No way. That's my one weakness.
What is
Oh, my goodness.
I might throw up just watching you eat that.
Think I'm gonna get sick?
Dude, you're disgusting. You know that? You can't take you anywhere.
I'm telling y'all, this is really good. It's good. That's one way right there to get full.
The boys are well fed and rested, so even though it's raining and the conditions are less than ideal, we thought they'd have no problem navigating from a nearby Rio beach to their target destination, Ipanema.
This is Rob's Rio right here. Some freaking Rio this is.
Try to have fun, will you? You're in Rio de Janeiro.
Never mind the weather.
It's tropical.
We picked out their next way, thinking if they could work with an ostrich, they'd have no problem with a swan. They jump on the baddest-looking pirate swan they can find and set sail.
Hunter's not working.
If I can reach I can make it turn.
Oh, man, this is a dumb idea.
This is the stupidest freaking thing we've done yet, dude.
Isn't this your idea?
No.
Is the motor on?
I got it, yeah, but I'm steering it with this.
Okay, here we go. Let's go straight. Hold on, right into it.
But the rudder. Rudder just broke.
I think I'm getting seasick, Rob.
Swan's way was a bust.
Let's get off this freaking thing.
On three. One, two, three.
They abandoned ship to find a better way.
Come on, Robbie.
One problem. Whatever Spanish Rob knew to get around in Peru,
is this yours?
Can I use this?
Oh. Was no help in the Portuguese-speaking Brazil.
Posso mostrar, cara, mas é complicado para ele de primeira, entendeu? Eu tenho que esperar até esse vento diminuir pouco aí. Porque o vento quando entra.
We have to find another way to get out of here.
Rio's been wet, not too good to us so far.
They strike out with the motorized ultralight thingy.
I know. Well, hey, we had a good spot here at the marina, baby. Check this out.
But strike gold at a marina with a jet ski.
Ride that thing?
Yes, sir.
We need to get some horsepower to get across this bay.
More like fool's gold.
You gotta be kidding me.
You can't even get it started.
All right, that's another way that didn't work.
I never thought it would be so difficult to find different ways to cart our butt around town.
Come on, Dennis, we gotta find a way out of here. Let's go.
There's a helicopter, an airplane. It's a bird.
They got monster trucks here?
No.
Let's get a ride with the policeman.
I bet you could do that.
You want to do that?
I'll tell you what, go up there and slap a big old dent right in the middle of his hood. He'll give us a ride.
Come on.
We're going to get locked up. Who is this guy?
You
want to
have a little ride? No problem, my friend.
Come on, can we come?
Nope. We can't get a ride?
Nope. This ain't even funny, man. We need to find something soon.
It's a new day. The boys had their chance to try and get to Ipanema by sea.
Oh, man, this is a dumb idea.
They failed. Now they have to get there by land.
Saturating the brush.
But first, we gave them a job.
All right, heads up. These guys are flying right here in this truck. Oh,
yeah! What better way for two world travelers than a road line painter?
Look it, I'm getting the hang of it now.
Keeping it good and straight.
A little highway safety never hurt anybody. In the long and winding history of roads, painted center lines are a relatively new invention. The first one appeared in 1917 on M15, a highway in Michigan, And it was one particular stretch of M15 that inspired this safety advance, Dead Man's Curve.
Go. Whoa, 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 whoa!
High in the mountains above Ipanema Beach, Dennis and Rob have been doing a little community service.
Go. Whoa, 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 whoa! Straighten out! You're off the road. Where are you going?
Right now, it doesn't look like our line painters are thinking very straight.
Don't go on the paint, it's still wet. Wet paint!
Ah, right through it.
Right through
God! Dennis, you know what? That gives me an idea.
Maybe the paint fumes are getting to them.
Dude, this is gonna be great. This is much more efficient this way.
So we can do it a lot faster.
That way we'll get double the coverage in half the time. Okay, now go straight. Go straight. Slow. Slow, slow!
Dennis is honestly like 2 years old. This is not a monster truck. The only thing monster about this truck is Dennis in it.
Dude, we made a mess. We gotta get out of here. Come on, let's go.
Rob, I didn't know it was doing that, dude.
You didn't know. You were playing games the whole time.
Rob and Dennis have made it to Sugarloaf Mountain, which stands high above their destination, Ipanema Beach.
Yeah! We finally made it, dude.
Ipanema Beach. Man, this is awesome up here, isn't
it?
Yeah,
it looks awesome. Look at this.
You all right?
God. You gotta be kidding me, dude.
Yeah, that's unreal.
The beach lies 1,000 feet below, and Rob finally reveals the way he wants to go.
Jeez, dude.
You want to take that?
No way, man. I'm not doing that, Rob.
Well, I'm taking that, and I'm getting down to the beach.
You got to be kidding me, dude. You going to leave me here by myself?
You figure it out. You're a big boy.
After hanging it over the edge on a zip line and clinging to the side of a Sao Paulo building and a window washer, Dennis has had enough of high wire danger.
I tell you what, boss, I'll be waiting on the beach for you when you get there.
There's no way. Let's put a little wager on it. What do you say?
All right, let's
see. The loser has to get a traditional Brazilian wax.
Ooh, that's gonna be painful for you, buddy.
I'm not the one with all the hair, Bigfoot. All right, we're on.
Nothing represents man's yearning to fly better than the hang glider. The first heavier-than-air flight was attempted by Abbas Furnas in the 9th century. Using a homemade glider wing, he jumped off a building in Cordova, Spain, and broke his back. There were several more attempts in the early 1900s, but the modern hang glider had its roots in a 1961 NASA experiment called the Parasev. Flexible wing development was then taken on by enthusiasts in the free-flying 60s and 70s, until it became the worldwide joyride it is now. The bed has been laid down and the race is on. While Dennis starts his long trek down the mountain, Rob gets close and personal with the hang gliding instructor.
But it's not 3D, man, it's 10D.
How you feeling? Feel good.
You're going to be hanged in 2 carabiners, look, on the right.
Okay.
Each one for 6,000 pounds.
It's a good thing you took another way down, Dennis, because these carabiners, they're only rated for 6,000 pounds each.
Sir, it is here. That's the crown for the American prince. Welcome. Cool. Remember, your happiness is my emotional food as I'm getting fed.
Okay.
Give me your hand. Thank you.
Thank you. I feel like you guys paid extra for this guy with all the sentimental
And Rob, before we take off, we're going to lie down to make a hang check.
Okay.
To check how comfortable and safe we are. Always checking, cross-checking, checking. Okay?
Okay.
The eagle must be far from us.
Feelings. There's a lot of feelings.
Dennis stops for a cold treat.
Go, go, faster, faster. Excellent, Rob, excellent.
While things are heating up between Rob and his happy glide partner.
Excellent. The best thing, give me a hand. If you don't know, the other one.
Take a look, go on.
Hey.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Oh, this is beautiful.
How was it?
Awesome.
Looks like Dennis didn't just buy an ice cream. He bought the whole damn cart.
Hey! Damn. Come on, baby. Come on. You put your hand here.
No hands, Dennis!
You can put your hand here, please. More. Okay.
Dad, I gotta stop this. Oh!
Woo! Unbelievable.
Yeah. What is this, surfing?
Surfing. Look, yeah. Okay, let's surf together here, like a...
Whoa!
Hey, watch out, watch out. Coming through. Ice cream. Cold ice cream. Get your ice cream right here.
Now, let's prepare for a perfect landing, okay?
Okay.
Lift up your right knee, please. You will fall more here. You will fall a little bit, don't worry.
Okay.
Arch your back, more than me. Happy landing, my friend.
Okay.
What took you so long there, hero?
You got something more your speed, huh?
But I got here before you did. That's all that counts.
Man, as long as you had fun.
I did, man. That looked great.
Man, what you got for me?
A nutty buddy for my nutty buddy. You came in, you looked scared, Rob.
No, I'm not. I'm not trying to be. It was fun. It was
really?
Awesome, yeah. Come on, let's go get a beer. You can tell me about it over lunch. Dude, my instructor was so hands-on.
Was he?
Oh, yeah.
I swear, I thought he was going to start the cup of feel when we were up there.
This week, the boys used 8 ways of transportation to get to Ipanema Beach.
Oh, my goodness.
1 gave them a great view. 3 were horse-powered. 2 were self-powered.
Can you go a little faster?
1, they flew like a bird. Another was for the birds.
Oh, come on, babe.
Only 63 more ways to go.
Dude, this is the place you found for me?
Yes, sir.
Man, this is one bet I'm not happy about losing.
There you go, buddy. Come on, pretty boy. You lay on your back, and we'll get him, like, right across here.
Just remember, brother, what goes around comes around.
I think I'm going to do it.
What about the warning? Maybe you should find out how to do it first. Hey, buddy.
Hold on, dude. Wait. No, I am. Let me do it.
Hold on. No, no. Hold on. First, and then you can do it.
No, I got it, dude.
You know what the hell
yes,
doing?
I do. I've seen this done before, man.
On your marks, get set.
Let's pull all 11 hairs.
Bro, look what you did.
Got a smooth patch right through here. Look.
Coming up, the boys are going to Africa.
No way!
Damn it, Dennis!
Yo.